Skylark, Chapter 12. We woke to a new sound, a sound I hadn't heard for months. I ran to the window. Rain. Anna! I turned, and Caleb and I grinned at each other. We dressed quickly and ran downstairs. Rain came down, filling the rain gutters. It sent little rivers down into the driveway. Everything smelled sweet. Caleb spread his arms and ran out into the rain in his clothes, racing around the yard. I laughed and ran after him. We jumped and ran, feeling the cool water run down our faces. We looked up. Sarah stood on the porch. She smiled. And, very slowly, she walked down the steps. Then she ran down the lawn to take our hands and dance with us. Rain, Sarah called to them. It's been so long. William came up from the water in his yellow slicker, which is a raincoat, and hat to watch too. Then, laughing, he took off his slicker to dance with us until the ants made us come up and dry off with towels. We were sorry to see the sun come out. I remember when you were little, William said to Sarah, running, climbing. You were always in the trees, out on the rocks. You never stayed still. Suddenly, Sarah looked at William. Do you remember a song Papa used to sing about a skylark? She asked. William smiled. A poem. I only remember the first line. Like a skylark, Sarah sings. Papa said you'd never come to Earth. Sarah looked out over the sea, and I knew she was thinking of Maggie's words to her on the dry prairie. Words I wasn't supposed to hear. You are like the prairie lark, Sarah. You have not wrote Papa a letter. We are fine. Fishing and rowing. And sometime, right soon, ants had tea in the moonlight. Almost, but not. I followed Aunt Lou down. She looks and goes skinny dipping. Sad sound. She looks.